This is the application for the X-Sense water sensor and base station. Here you can see everything is listed out that I have attached to the X-Sense account. Right now I have it listed by devices, but I can select rooms and it will change the layout of this. There's also a room management option right down there, but we're gonna change that back to devices because that's the view that I prefer. And then if I come over to homes, if I have multiple homes, let's say I'm keeping these in a rental property, I could set up different homes so that I can keep track of the water sensors and where they are and if they're going off in a particular area. In the upper right-hand corner, we have our emergency. So there is a service that you can get, a protection plan. This is how you would access that. I am not currently utilizing that. The upper right-hand corner next to that, there is a plus sign. This is how you can add more devices to your account. So right here, this is our device list. If I hit my toggle right there, I can have them more of a card view or this list view. I kind of like the list view, so that's what I'm gonna leave it at. Right here, we have our base station. You can see it's got its label. It's letting you know that it's online, and I can select share right there, and then please enter a valid email address that you wish to share this with, and then an alias for that user, and then what you'd like to share. In this case, it would have been the base station. But I'm going to select the sprocket icon, which brings us into the actual options for the base station. That would be the same as if I just tapped on the base station image itself. You get a nice depiction of what it is right there. You have your naming convention, so I just called it base station. You can tell what room it's in. So right now I have it as part of my living room. I can move that to a different location if I wanted to. We also have our volume control for min-max because there is a speaker on the base station itself, letting you know if there's a water alarm or an alarm elsewhere. Now we have our silent alarm on the back of the base station. There is a button. This option will allow you to use that button to turn off an alarm, so silence it. Right down here, we have our Wi-Fi network, device information, which I'm not going to show you because there's a lot of sensitive information in there, and then device sharing, so similar to how we did before, except right within the settings. And that's everything that you can do with the base station. Now, coming into our actual water detection devices, we could see a blue progression that lets us know, hey, this is its Wi-Fi connectivity, as well as a battery icon next to it. There are three bars in that battery icon, letting you know how much battery is left per device. Again, if we tap on a singular device, that will bring us in, or we could select the setting sprocket to the right to get us access. Again, a nice depiction of the device itself, as well as its network connection and battery percentage. We have our name right here. Tapping on that will allow you to edit the name if you want to. I'm going to cancel out of that. Again, room, where is this located? Again, if you're creating these room groups, you can do that right from here by selecting add another. Device information, again, sensitive information in there. It'll show you firmware, things like that, device MAC address. Here we have test device. Now, this is sitting slightly off camera. Bring this into focus and cover that up so it doesn't get too loud. But we're gonna test the device, cover up the sound, and give that a second to test. You see blinking, red light, and it made a noise, but I made it muted by covering that up. So we're gonna say, yep, that worked. And we're gonna go back. We're done. We know we are confirming that we're ending that test. Here we have device settings, volume control for the puck itself, min-max, and then what specific tone you'd like to have for the base station. So right now it's on tone 1. I can change it to tone 3. Tone 2, tone 1, and you could do that per puck. So in my case, if I have 3 pucks, I could change the sound so that each puck made a different noise. I'm just gonna leave it on that right now. So those were our sounds. We have help and feedback. So again, this is going to be built-in help for your devices. And then coming down here, we have our notifications. So will you get a push notification per alarm trigger, alarm end, device silenced, device test, and low battery. You are able to limit your notifications. I pick the ones that I prefer to see pop up. And then all the way down here at the bottom, we can select remove device, and that will remove it from our actual lineup here. Now that's all under our home icon right there. If we come over to history, this will show you a history of what has happened. So right here you can see device test, and it lets you know which one was tested. And then right here, water leak was triggered, and we can come up to our calendar icon right there, and you'll notice if there's a red dot, that indicates when something happened. So in this case, tested, there was a leak. I silenced the device, no more leaks, put it back in place, and it triggered again, but then I turned it off and there were no more leaks. I can filter, so I could say, what do I want to filter for? So which particular one? So here you can see the naming convention is probably a good idea to kind of put where the device is located up front as opposed to what it is first. So food for thought, just kind of let you know what that looks like. And then within our account, we have our name up top here, which is going to be all your personal information. Not going to show that. We've got our manage home. So here's the current home that I have, what we've got going on. And if I want to add another home, I can. Works with Alex A. Well, there are specific items that work with Alex A because the home base is accessible with other XSense devices. The water sensors are not one of them. They list out right here the two that are currently accessible. And that is going to be the same with Google Assistant. You need to have these specific ones to work with Google Assistant. The water ones do not work. That's not bad, but just know. We have our alarm sound. So sound the alarm. Not only can your device puck itself and the base station sound an alarm, this will also have your phone make that noise as well. Protection plan, again, kind of saw that on the front page, but this is another place that you can access it for the free trial. Then we have our help and feedback, again, accessible from another place, but right here kind of brings up what it thinks you're looking for right away as opposed to that other screen. And then about XSense, and it's just letting you know, hey, there's everything you need to know. And we're gonna come back to our home because that is everything for the XSense water sensor as well as base station that you can do within the XSense